Congo that this bloody situation could get even worse. Tom?
Our fifth story out front. The election is barely behind us, but speculation is already shifting to who will be running in the next cycle. Can you stand it? I can't. One name bandied about is former Florida Governor Jeb Bush. That's right, the brother of President George W. Bush, part of the Bush political dynasty. Maria Cardona, CNN contributor, Democratic strategist, and a principal at the Dewey Group, joins us now, along with Ryan Salam, CNN contributor and National Review writer. Ryan, let me start with you about this whole thing. Is Jeb Bush really going to run?
Well, it's not clear right now, but I'll say this. Jeb Bush is widely regarded as a tremendously effective political operator and as having been a very successful governor of Florida. And the truth is that had his name been Smith instead of Bush, I think that a lot of people would have been wondering why he didn't run this time around. So I think that he's a very formidable contender who brings a lot of assets to the table, including a very strong connection to the Latino community in his state.
You bring up a really good point here. If you're a Democrat or you're a Democrat side of the equation, you're saying, sure, give us another Bush to run against because we think the Bush name is somewhat poisoned right now, Maria. But Jeb Bush is fluent in Spanish. He's married to a woman who grew up in Mexico. He has strong ties with Latino communities in a big state with a big Latino vote. This is the kind of guy who could put Democrats on the defensive on this, isn't it?
Well, he certainly would give us a whole lot more competition than Mitt Romney did, that's for sure. But that's actually not saying much. Jeb Bush absolutely, I think, is a tremendous leader when it comes to the issues that are important to Latinos, for example, immigration and education. He's got a very good name ID among Latino voters. He does have a Mexican wife, is fluent in Spanish. Is very comfortable the same way his brother, George W. Bush, was around Latinos. And that is half the battle right there. But I think the problem for Jeb Bush is absolutely his namesake, his legacy. And, you know, I know that a lot of people might be sick of legacies and people are talking about Hillary Clinton in 2016. But if it is, for example, Hillary Clinton and Jeb Bush in 2016, a lot of voters are going to think back to the last Bush and the last Clinton and make a comparison. And that's not a comparison that Jeb Bush will win by any means.
All right, both of you, just because I can't stand talking about 2016 yet, let's talk about the Senate race in 2014, Ryan. Quick question here. Senators McConnell, Graham, Cornyn, Chambliss, all are thought to be vulnerable to the Tea Party. I guess my question here is what do you think is going to happen in the next couple of years? Because the Republicans have to sort this out, how much they're going to lean more toward the base or more toward the fiscal conservatives in the Tea Party, or are they going to go more toward the middle? And in the end, can they get the Senate back?
Well, I think getting the Senate back is going to be tough to do, and it's going to depend on candidate recruitment, particularly in states like Alaska and Colorado and Louisiana, where you have pretty Republican electorates, but you have Democratic senators coming from those states. Now, as for this Tea Party insurgency idea, look, when you look at this cycle in 2012, if you look at 2010 as well, you had a lot of insurgent conservative candidates who ran successfully against firmly well-established candidates who had won statewide a number of times before. It's not obvious to me that you're going to see a ton of donors and a ton of activists who are going to be fired up about that come 2014, having seen that the result of those Tea Party insurgencies in some cases threatened a winnable Republican candidate. So my guess is that you're going to see some moderation on that front, if only to win winnable swing states.
Maria, let me ask you something about this. If I were a Democrat, you know what I'd fear in the Senate race? I would look at the most recent races and say, if it weren't for some Republicans roaming off in the woods and shooting themselves mm-hmm. in the foot, mm-hmm. the Democrats would not have done as well. And that's something that Democrats can't take too lightly as they head into the midterms.
Oh, absolutely, Tom. I think you're absolutely right. It will no doubt be very difficult in 2016, but it was very difficult this time around. In 2014. And 2014 is, just by the sheer math of it, going to be harder than it supposedly would have been this time around for Republicans. Republicans blew it. Can Democrats count, though, on Republicans blowing it in the next 2 years? No. But that's why you see all of those Democrats who are up in 2014 going to continue to focus on the issues that their constituents care about. And Mary Landrieu is very good at that. Mark Begich is very good at that from Louisiana and Alaska. And so I think that if they focus on the issues that are important to their constituencies without regard to where the Democrats are, I think that they have a very good chance of winning re-election, and the Democrats have a good chance of keeping the Senate.
I think it's good advice for anybody. Never count on your enemy dropping out of the race, basically. Rayhan, Maria, thanks for being here. Out front next, an investigation launched into the death of a 31-year-old woman centering on the explosive issue of abortion rights.
If you're one of the millions of men who have used Androgel 1%, there's big news. Presenting Androgel 1.62%. Both are used to treat men with low testosterone. Androgel 1.62% is from the makers of the number one prescribed testosterone replacement therapy. It raises your testosterone levels and is concentrated so you could use less gel. And with Androgel 1.62%, you can save on your monthly prescription.
Dosing and application sites between these products differ. Women and children should avoid...